passing has sent shockwaves through the Republican family. Tommy was a son of Derry, a great sportsman, and a Celtic fanatic. But primarily, he was a fearless IRA soldier. When Republicans speak of struggle, speak of sacrifice, speak of courage, Tommy Roberts' name is one of the first that enters our thoughts. Tommy led from the front and would never ask a fellow volunteer to do something he would not do himself. His dedication to the freedom struggle saw him incarcerated in every jail in Ireland. Even when imprisoned, the enemy feared Tommy's resolution, so much so they tried to have him poisoned. Tommy saw active service with Junior McDade, a friend, a comrade. He was an active service with Junior when he was killed, and his dedication and loyalty to Junior continued as Tommy, even though ill himself, would strive to be a Junior's commemoration. Tommy never wavered in his dedication to his beloved volunteer and ex-POW wife, Molly. He was a Republican of high values and morals. He was unrepentant. And make no mistake, he was and always will be remembered and honoured as a dedicated volunteer who lived his life to uphold the principles of the 1916 proclamation. I used to pick Tommy's brains at a young age down in Bunkanna, and I am proud to say that Tommy is a beacon of light for me, and he should be a beacon of light for this generation of Republicans who strive to achieve the goal that Tommy fought so courageously for. Tommy Roberts is not ashamed of his past, and as was shown during his week, those Republicans who fight for the same freedom that Tommy believed in paid him with a fitting tribute. Tommy was a true and faithful IRA volunteer. His noble and just cause is our noble and just cause. Tommy Roberts was not bought. He did not waver. He stood firm. And it is right that we honour, in the only fitting way possible, for Tommy and all his fallen comrades who now rest in peace with, the ultimate honour, a 32-county Socialist Republic.